All right, guys, well, as you can see here, if you remember from part one, this is our crossbow right here. I've taken all of the metal off of it, so it is just a bare stock. It's very, very simple. Probably took me a grand total of 10 minutes. I did figure out why this limb was loose. Basically, there is a little catch piece right here that sits on it, hooks into it, and then it feeds through a hole to the underside of the stock where a nut was missing that tightens down on it and that holds the limb tight. So that's good to know that that's easy fix. There's nothing wrong with it. So basically all that, and then the rest of it is just little hardware, little bits of screws. And they were smart back then when they made this. Once again, I have no idea when this thing was produced. I'm going to go inside later and do a lot more research on it. But every single one of the screws for this thing, well, not that one, all these screws that mount all the hardware is all the exact same size, which is very convenient. So basically, what I'm going to do is, I know I'm not keeping this stirrup. I'm either going to modify it or make a new one, because you can't fit your boot there. I mean, put my boot up here, there's no way that's going to fit. So I'm going to have to make that a little bit bigger, which is not a big deal. And I'll just do the same thing where I do a little hook around to try and make a catch, because this is what catches onto the stirrup and keeps it from slipping through. It'll make more sense here. Yeah, you can see the stock right here has two slots on either side to hold the stirrup, like so. And then this piece simply goes on right here to block in the stirrup, like so. So I'll just make sure and do a good hook there, so that way this will catch it nicely, and that'll be good. So pretty much my plan now is to sand this stock completely down to bare wood, and hopefully tonight go ahead and put a coat of stain on there. Probably one of many coats. I'll probably do a stain, lightly sand, do another stain, because I want this thing to be really, really nice when it's done. Since I'm going to have this thing for a really long time, I want to do a good job on it. Pretty much the only thing that is non-functioning, has a little bit of a hiccup that needs to be replaced or fixed. The trigger mechanism worked perfectly fine until I took it apart, did a little tinkering, and there's a tiny little barrel spring that is on one of these holes, or on one of the pins. Let me see if I can get a light to where you guys can see this. As you can see right there, there's the barrel spring. If this thing was actually focused, let me get a little bit tighter light on there. This is the barrel spring. Since it's old, one of the actual pins and the ends that actually makes the spring function, it broke. So basically that means... Alright guys, well, I think I'm pretty much done for the night. I'm pretty tired. I got about half of the sanding done, maybe just a little bit less than half the sanding done. As you can see, this side is almost completely done, and we have the other side left to go. Done about a little bit past the width of it, sanding-wise, so pretty much I only have this one face left to go, and this little bit of a pocket here is a little bit harder to sand, so it's taking a little bit longer. Up here, for some reason, I think the grain is just a little bit darker, so it seems to be taking a little bit longer. As you can see, the layers of grain are coming up, so it's a little bit rough right there as well. But I'll just continue to sand that. I'm not too worried about right here, because as you can see, you know, that's where the furniture sits or the hardware. So I'm not concerned about that, because you'll never see it. So I'm not too worried about it. But besides that, yeah, it's coming along well. I'm going to go in and do some research and see if I can get maybe another bow for this thing. We'll see how that goes. Maybe it'll be worth it, maybe it won't. But besides that, you know, for the only $15 I'm invested in it, I'm pretty happy. And it's coming along well. So that'll pretty much be it for the night. I'll pick it up again, and you guys will see this in about 2 more seconds probably, because I'll continue to add on to this video. I won't make this into a separate video, but it might be a couple days for me. But besides that, see y'all guys in a little bit. Okay, well, good morning, guys. So last night we finished sanding up the stock. I would have liked to get a coat of stain on this stock last night, but I was having a problem with the colors, and you know, coming out this morning, I can't quite figure out what color that I would like to use. I really, really wanted to use this nice dark color that I used on my axe handle. As you can see, my buddy Mason broke it last camp out, but you know, I really, really liked that color, and it's a nice dark color, and that's what I was going for. But I've looked through every single stain I have, and I can't seem to find it. So the next best choice I found is going to be this stuff. It's just a Mastercraft polyurethane gel wipe-on stain. Alright, so it's not looking like that is going to want to come out. It lightened up just a little bit, but I think we're just going to have to deal with it. It's not, you know, a work of art. It's just a, well, it is a work of art, but, you know, you do what you can. I'm not going to obsess over it. It's just going to get beat up in the woods, so I'm not going to get too carried away with, you know, perfection. But I definitely want to do a good job because, you know, I take pride in my work, and I don't want to just do a, you know, a lazy job. Alright everybody, well, I'll be perfectly honest with you. I put that coat on there and I thought it looked like crap. It was way too light for what I wanted, and I really didn't like it. I really wanted that dark, rich color, and so, you know, I did some more looking, and I found a can. This is the one I was using. I found a can that had been basically glued shut. Some stain had gotten up in the lid and glued it shut. And so I cracked that one open, and lo and behold, it was the exact same one I used for this. So I went ahead, took the time, about 20 minutes, and just sanded off that old coat. So I'm taking the tack cloth now and getting it off the last bit of sawdust. And I think I got probably 95% of the old stain off, but I mainly just wanted to get enough off that this new stain would penetrate. So as long as it penetrates through, then we should be fine. And I'm going to do probably two coats of this. So I'll do this coat, and then I'll lightly sand and do a second coat. And then after that, it'll be a couple coats of polyurethane. But, you know, I had an idea in my head of what I wanted, and I really didn't want to have to compromise that at all. And so I decided it was worth it. It only took, you know, 20 minutes to take that old coat off. And I think when you guys see me put this on this time, you'll agree with me that it's going to look beautiful compared to that old one, because that old one just brought out all the imperfections. You could really see that back part, that darker part, and I just didn't like it as much. So hopefully I got all the stain off to where this new stain will penetrate. We'll see what happens. I was a little bit mad though when I took the mouse, the hand sander, and sanded this time. I could tell it put some minute scratches throughout it. So I'm hoping those will disappear with this coat. And if I have to, you know, well, hopefully if it doesn't disappear with this coat when I do my second coat, hopefully it will kind of disappear. But here's this new stain, as you can see, much darker. This will probably be the last time I can use this stuff anyway. There's not a whole lot left, and it's pretty clumpy. But I just did not want to compromise. So let's take a look. I'm going to get something underneath all this stuff, so in case it spills. Let's take a look at this stuff. Yeah. Much nicer. Alright, so the next step in the process, while that stock's drying, it's been drying for probably, I don't know, 2 hours now. I have these side plates that were basically cover plates for the sides of the main trigger mechanism. And they have a little bit of rust on them, but they have some nice scrolling done on them, and the logo Powermaster. And so I think that would look really nice, polished to like a mirror polish. So I'm going to go ahead and take some sandpaper and just hit the top of it to start with. That scrolling is already starting to come out. So I don't know if you guys can see that. You might not be able to see the scrolling. There you go. You can see just a little bit of it. Nice scrolling where it says Power Master. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the Dremel tool. I had to move outside because literally the garage is... I've made so much of a mess that I can't even work in there hardly anymore. Alright, well, I'm not sure how well you can tell the difference, but this is what it looked like originally, and this is what I got it to. Obviously, it's not a mirror polish. I could tell, obviously, as soon as I started that, you know, if it's not really mirrored and shiny to start with, it's going to take a ton of work to get it anywhere close to a mirror polish. So, I'm not into that, you know, making it that pretty, so I'm just going to do, you know, what I did there, which is take that white rouge and just go all the way across it. This one hasn't even had the sandpaper put on it yet, so you can tell, big difference. This one, you can very easily read it. It's got a really nice shine to it. You can really see the scrolling in it, and it looks very, very nice. So, I'll keep it this way. I'm not going to paint these at all. These will be the only pieces of raw metal on there, so it'll be a nice accent to it. And it'll be a cool-looking feature to add onto the side pieces of that mechanism, because right now, they'll just be... they'll be standard black, so this will give it a really nice pop. So, let me go ahead and pretty much finish this one, and we're almost there in terms of our restoration, guys, so stay tuned. So this is the trigger guard. This is one of a couple pieces that are getting painted black. Decided the only thing I'm going to keep original color will be the Powermaster scrolling plates. I like the look of it being all black, especially since the scope going on it is going to be solid black. So I figured it would complement it. Alright guys, well, we've let our stain dry for most of the day. I did this early in the morning, and it's early afternoon-ish, so I've given it quite enough hours, I do believe. As you can see, the stain looks really quite beautiful. Nice and dark the way I wanted it to. Most of the impurities, or you know, imperfections, have been pretty readily masked. It does have a little bit of lighter tones here and there, because I only did one coat. I really like the look of that, so I'm going to keep it. And I did a very heavy coat to start with, so I'm not too concerned about it. I'm definitely going to do a couple coats of polyurethane, more than likely three coats, to really protect it, though, to make sure that this nice finish will stay like this for a long, long time. So I'm just going to use some basic polyurethane, some Minwax fast-drying polyurethane. And it says... to do a light sanding, which I did do. I did just a very, very light sanding with a very high grit sandpaper, and then took the tack cloth to it again to get all the fine dust off. It says apply a thin coat, and then let dry to 3 to 4 hours, lightly sand again, and do a second coat. So basically every 3 to 4 hours you can do another coat. So I'll probably get two coats on today. Well, let me see what time it is. I can actually get three coats on today. I'll do one now, one at 6, and I'll come out at 9 and do another one. I'm just using a very small foam brush to apply this because that's what it recommended. You don't really want this stuff to run at all. You want to do very light, thin coats. What I just did right there was probably a bit too much. So I'm going to go ahead and spread that around quite a bit. Let me move this before I spill it. Yeah, that was a bit thick, so I'm going to spread that around quite a bit. And that just gives it the most beautiful shine to it. Wow, that looks nice. It's a little bit tricky doing this poly because, first of all, it's hard to keep it from running. You have to be very careful. If you put too much on, it's going to start running. And second of all, it's hard to tell what areas you've done and what areas you haven't. And I'm sure that'll get even harder on the second and third coats. But do the best you can. Kind of have to let the light hit it a certain way. And you can sort of see what part's glossy and what part isn't. I just absolutely love the way that it made this thing shine.
Doesn't that look pretty? It's been about 2 hours since I put that coat of poly on there. I'm going to give it about another hour and put one more coat on. I may not do three. I don't know. The second one looks like it'll probably be plenty durable. You can see the shine on that's just really nice. Really, really nice. Didn't really expect to generate this much of a mess to do this one little project. I mean, one crossbow is going to take, and it's taken this whole garage turning into an absolute mess. But I guess that's how it goes. So we're winding down on the amount of stuff we have to do left. As you can see, my scope right here, I'm in the works on how to put that onto crossbow since there's no real intuitive way to do it. I'm guessing what I might have to do is get a buddy and we weld the top plate right here of the mechanism, the trigger mechanism, to these pieces down here. Get that welded on like so, and that might be the way I do it. Either that or get this tube, piece of aluminum tubing, and weld that on first, and then put this on to give me just a little bit more clearance between. Obviously, it would only be about here to here, the aluminum tubing. That will give me some more clearance between the top of the scope and the rail that the bolt is going to slide on, just to give the vanes a little bit of room. So we'll see how that goes. But besides that, that's pretty much the last thing to do. I'm probably not going to put this front sight back on. If I do, I might just make a cut in between the two of them just so I can drop the arrow in instead of having to slide it underneath. I'll just drop it in on top, and this will mainly just be for aesthetic effect. But pretty much that's done. My plates right here are finished. My scroll plates, the etching plates, those are done. They look nice. And then all the rest of the stuff is out getting painted right now. The paint's drying on that. So really, hopefully tomorrow, depending on when I can get this welded, we can do some final assembly, get everything put together. I have a string on order already, so that's going to go ahead and get put on there pretty soon. Got the prod sitting right here. And that's pretty much it. So we're winding down, but it's definitely taking a while and a lot of resources to try and get it all put together. But I think, you know, when it all gets put together with that really nice stock, you know, glowing really nice with this nice shiny scroll work here, and then a nice, good, powerful, high quality scope on there. I mean, it's gonna be a really, really nice piece. So stay with me, guys.